constructs key conversations. CED Magazine platform honor engineer Olumuyiwa Alade Ajibola, fellow NSC and fellow Academy of Engineering, as he celebrates his 70th birthday. He speaks on the unlocking the potential of engineering for economic growth. We have a report. The integrity-driven engineer Innocent Akrugwe, fellow of the Nigerian Society of Engineers, is behind the highly successful GGI International Limited. On our focus segment today on Inside Business, Engineer Akrugwe is to speak on the performance, offering, and position of GGI International in the Nigerian economy. Plus, Inside Business Africa hosts IBCA Opal Award ceremony on Friday. Find out who is getting what and what's going to happen at that event. This is Inside Business Africa, Africa's business news and information leader. Hello and thanks for joining us. My name is Kenneth Odushola Stevenson and this is Inside Business Africa, Africa's business news and information leader. Like you may have heard on the highlight, we will be highlighting what took place in Lagos last week. The Construct Key platform that put together a very important event to honor engineer Olumuyiwa Ajibola, a fellow of the Nigerian Society of Engineers and past president of the society. We'll talk about all that, plus a very other important issues on business, finance, and the economy. We'll talk about all that when we come back right after this commercial break. Welcome back. You're still Inside Business Africa, Africa's business news and information leader. Thanks for staying with us. Indeed, it was a very eventful day on Thursday last week in Lagos when engineer Olumuyiwa Ajibola was honored with a very important Construct Scale conversation platform by CED Magazine to celebrate his 70 years as a person and also 40 years in the built environment as an engineer. Inside Business Africa was there. Here's what we brought for you. Take a listen. Construct Key Conversation 7, a construction and engineering digest magazine platform designed to discuss and reflect on issues, people and personalities, and the achievement of professionals in the built environment, engineering, oil and gas and allied sector. Hosted engineer Olumuyiwa Alade Ajibola, fellow NSC, fellow Academy of Engineering and past president of the Nigerian Society of Engineers, as part of his 70th birthday, to an interactive discussion lecture focusing on his life, professional career under the theme Unlocking the Potentials of Engineering for Economic Growth. Engineer Ajibola, past president of the Nigerian Society of Engineers, with over 40 years dedicated to the engineering profession, highlighted the early foundation of his education and his decision to dedicate himself to engineering. Construct Key Conversation platform, specifically designed as a made-for-television session, has the founding editor-in-chief of CED Magazine, Oniwangu Stevenson, taking on the celebrants on various issues relating to his profession and the industry, among others.
And we're now got into it. Were you disappointed? Were you impressed? Did you see this your dream manifested when you finally got into the study of it?
I saw it. I must tell you, I was never disappointed. I saw the vast opportunity to be creative. And in fact, even though a lot of people felt that early engineers were more like rigid, formatted engineers, but I looked at a lot of things that happened and I saw a lot of creativity.
Engineer Ajibola at the event also presented a paper reflecting on the theme Unlocking the Potentials of Engineering for Economic Growth.
In his paper and discussion, Engineer Olumuyiwa Ajibola analyzed the present situation of Nigerian economy, praising the proposed steps listed by the government and policymakers necessary to solve the nation's economic problems, but criticized the execution of the said solution proffered so far as it's been executed at the detriment of Nigerian professionals who were not consulted nor included in the implementation.
Unlocking is something that's in a box or that's held in the compartment that is to be released. In other words, whatever is there is still there. It could be treasure, it could be water, it could be anything, but yet to be released until it is unlocked. If whatever potentials that it has cannot be known.
Emphasizing the need to strategize the approach to policy formulation and implementation, he bemoaned the non-inclusion of engineers at the formative level of policies, citing the Economic Recovery and Growth Plan ERGP 2017 to 2020 as an example. He also posited the need to tap the great potential of engineering to accelerate national development. Engineer Ajibola at the event also highlighted the need for the development and inclusion of local industries and local content, emphasizing the importance of convincing foreign investors to set up shops in the country in order to provide jobs for the increasing number of unemployed graduates.
I think the engineers are still working. Maybe not the engineers, I don't know. They have a place for growth, development, yet to come into engineering. And the entire body of knowledge and skills needed to give solutions.
Well, congratulations on your 70th birthday, Engineer Olumuyiwa Ajibola. We are very proud of you and your contribution to the built environment, the engineering sector, and indeed Nigeria. When we come back right after this commercial break, we'll talk about another engineer, Engineer Akuwe, who is the Chairman Chief Executive of GGI International Limited, a chemical manufacturing and production company. Indeed, you get to learn a lot. Stay with Inside Business. We'll be right back.
How would you like your construction and engineering industry news and information? Broad, complex, and difficult to read? Or sharp, ready to read and explore? Presenting Construction and Engineering Digest Magazine CED Refreshing Clarity in Construction and Engineering Industry News and Information. Construction and Engineering Digest Magazine CED incorporating oil and gas report with news and information that work for you.
He's still Inside Business Africa, Africa's business news and information leader. Thanks for staying with us. Indeed, Engineer Innocent Akuwe is the Chairman Chief Executive of GGI International Limited, a very important corporate Nigerian, and that particular organization has been doing a lot. But before we get to meet him, let's listen to this very short profile or presentation on the man and the company.
His achievements are too numerous to be ignored, and his success story is a testimony to the enduring power of vision, honesty, and integrity. Welcome to the world of Engineer Chief Sir Dr. Innocent Akuwe, the Chairman Chief Executive of GGI Groups Limited. In a chat with Inside Business Africa, Dr. Innocent Akuwe, the chairman of GGI Group, stressed that his company's steady success over the years is as a result of maintaining international best practices in all operations and in addition to ensuring integrity in business and in life. GGI Group Limited, a big player in the corporate Nigeria and internationally, has been able to compete favorably with foreign firms in the delivery of high-quality chemical products over the years.
Well, there you have it. That is a very important personality that is worth celebrating. I will tell you all about that again later on before the end of today's program. But in a very short while, I'll be bringing in Engineer Innocent Akuwe to Inside Business Africa to ask him some questions on what is driving him and how he's running the business, using integrity as the platform. Let me use this opportunity to welcome Engineer Akuwe to Inside Business Africa. Thank you again for joining us, sir.
Thank you very much.
Well, engineer, that doctor, sir, and chief, Innocent Akuwe, thank you again. Now, let me start from the beginning. GGI International Limited, what is it all about? And what has been the vision at inception, and how has the vision been managed to see the success you're recording today?
GGI International Nigeria Limited is a wholly Nigerian company. We always will say that this was the gift we gave to each other between me and my wife. It was incorporated in 1991 when we wedded, but typically kept in the bus, because then I was a pupil engineer working in an oil, a chemical process industry. So at the appropriate time, the documents were dusted off, and that's what we are saying today. Our vision is to be the best in our industry. Our mission is to hit the targets of the board of directors.
Well, thank you for that explanation. Let me go straight to the next question, which is the fact that we needed to know in clear terms the core areas and the offerings of GGI International, especially in Nigeria and internationally. Could you tell us that?
The core business of GGI International today is production, chemical, and treatment. You know, in the oil sector, there are various business areas. We started as a general supply company, later became a general chemical supply company, and then carved a niche for ourselves and ventured into production treatment. When we talk about production treatment, we're talking about the treatment of crude to give it export value, you know, because you might be surprised to know that when you hear that crude is sold for $50 a drum, it's not every crude that is sold for that. It's the very best of it that gets that price. So some companies will spend money, get quality for what they are, and get value for their product. Some who are reluctant to spend money, their crude could sell as low as $30 per drum.
Well, I know you are an engineer, Engineer Kiwe. You know, you have actually put in a very important performance, you know, into this organization. Now, you are a fellow of the Nigerian Society of Engineers. And for you to become a fellow, I know it took a long while, and also some kind of integrity-driven practice standards. And indeed, what actually attracted you to engineering, and indeed to the kind of business that your organization is running today?
It's not by chance. It's a dream, you know. Professional mechanical engineer, and I've always wanted to see myself in the act of practice of core chemical engineering, and this gave me the opportunity, and that opportunity actually came in 2010 when we had the privilege of being selected among others by GE Water and Process Technologies to represent them in Nigeria. And this arm of GE business deals on specialty chemicals. When we say specialty, these are special chemicals that are tailored for treatment of various crudes. You know, the crude you get in one location will not be exactly what you get in another location. So we normally use the term application specific. So these products are tailored to suit every treatment, you know. You do what we call a bottle test first, then you do what we call field trial. By the field trial, we're able to confirm the efficacy of your product on a particular crude, and then that crude gets that particular chemical for treatment.
Well, some other things we have made your company to stand out as a top performer, quality driven organization, integrity driven personality and people, and also the team you're working on. Now, let's look at it from that perspective. You know, what makes your company stand out in this area of business? And also, how do you utilize this platform integrity as one of the yardstick to drive the growth and the success of GGI?
I think the driving force here is integrity. Yes. The company has tried to maintain integrity in its business. And how do you get to achieving that? There are standards in the industry. What we did was to work hard to attain those the three major standards in the industry: ISO 9001, OSAS 18001 for safety, and then 14001 for environment. When you have ISO 9001, it's about management. It's about how to manage your company. You put a good management structure in place. You have us as 18,000 and one is for safety. It puts a safety structure in place. So what it means is that for you to maintain, for you to show integrity in what you're doing, you must be seen. Not, this is not a theory now. Mm-hmm. You must be seen to practice what is expected of you in the manuals of these standards. Okay? If I say this product is this, that product has to be that, no matter where you take it to. That's integrity. You know, if I make you an offer and I say that offer is valid for 90 days, that offer is valid for 90 days, except where there are very overriding circumstances which you yourself will see and agree with me. Okay? Otherwise, what you say should be your word should be your bond. You know, so that's what has kept us. If a customer calls us and said, GGI, do you have product A? And we don't have product A. We tell you we don't have product A, but we could get product A from a reliable company like ours.
Well, I know that everything in life is engineering, and engineering is life, engineering is growth, and we talked about it last week in Lagos. And indeed, I mean, we know that most of the components of your products and offerings are import dependent. But there must be some challenges that this industry is facing, especially your organization. Could you enumerate some of these and see how we could navigate the power of engineering to move forward in this sector?
Yeah, the industry, especially the oil and gas industry, of course, is going through a very difficult time. The crash in the crude price is a major factor. You know, that has also affected investments in the sector, because I mean, if you were selling crude at $100 or more per drum, and today you're not too sure of what it's going to be tomorrow, the tendency is for you to hold back your resources and say, ah, let me wait and see it first. And that has left a lot of problems, because, and it also kept a lot of job, because if you're not drilling, if you're not exploiting, a lot of companies are going to be idle. I give you an instance. If you're drilling a well, drilling one well will involve a lot of companies with different expertise, and that's how the ripple effect will continue. For example, if you're drilling a chemical, companies like ours will deliver drilling chemicals to you. Other companies will do drilling mud services. Others will offer cementing. A lot of activities are going to be involved, and that will trigger off more employment and all that. But right now it's difficult. I must tell you the truth, it is difficult. But we are hoping that now that there seems to be some stability in price, though not fantastic, but stability there, and now that also that the OPEC nations and the non-OPEC nations seem to agree to watch the quantum of crude they produce, I think that is what is creating the stability in the market. You know, so we're also hoping that that will give investors the confidence to come back to begin to invest in the industry. And once that happens, every bit of the economy will pick up.
Well, now I'm going to be a little bit personal. You know, looking back to your practice over the years and also how you've been able to, you know, do your business and run your life, it must have been some kind of a role model to quite a number of people. No, indeed, some manufacturers and engineering professionals. Now, there must have been some challenging times and some other areas where you feel that if I want to do it again, I will have done it better than what I've done. Can we look at some of those key areas and also see how we can learn a lesson from this? Some things you believe that we can learn from.
Yeah, I think it's quite that's a good one, because whenever I think back to when I started my career as a young engineer, that was in 1988. I was employed as a popular engineer in a process industry called Greenway Industries Limited. We were then lifting bulk ammonia from NAFCON, the then NAFCON, and processing it into ammonium hydroxide solutions, and also decanting straight into selling this. You know, and I look at that, and today I look at where I have gotten to, and I'm just like, wow, it's been quite a journey, you know. But what would I say? It's a journey of interest. It's a journey of commitment. At each level, at each stage of my career, I seem to be so contented with what I found myself in. as a young engineer in Greenways industry, I rose up to the position of a plant superintendent, and the owners of the company saw competence in me and moved me to another establishment under their holding company called Phyllis Chemical Industrial Limited. And there I was transferred to as a project engineer. And you know, it was actually in Phyllis that I began to get close to the industry, oil industry, because we were now interfacing with companies like the refineries, you know. And because there are a lot of regulations in this industry, you need to know how to get certain permits for you to be able to work in these areas. So again, that brought me to knowing about DPR, because along the line we also had an LPG plant. I told the designed that plant and built it, got the necessary approvals, you know, and I saw happiness, I saw joy, I saw fulfillment, because each time I made presentation to the board, I see smiles on the directors' faces, and I was like, well, it seems I'm doing it right, you know. So when eventually I had to leave to begin this business, because this is more like a family business between myself and my wife, Engineer Betty Akovwe, who is a petroleum engineer, you know, so it was like, wow, the right time I was here. And I left with the blessings of my boss at the time, and we started this young company then, and continued to grow it until we're here now.
Engineer Dr. Asa and Chief Akuwe. Now, the follow-up to that question will be, what is your dream for the industry where you are currently operating, and also for the engineering practice and profession in this industry, and also the Nigerian environment? What would be your dream? What would you like to see? Take, for instance, in the next 5 or 10 years to see changes that must take place for the growth to appear.
The dream for this place is for us to hit the peak of the industry. And that peak is to someday begin to exploit for crude, just like the people we are working for. That's the dream, you know. But I have a principle, or we have a principle as a board here. We believe in growing steadily. For every growth, you stabilize before you move to the next one, you know. So here we are today, offering services we never knew we could. Tomorrow we don't know what could happen. But what we have done is to put the right things in place. Okay? Create the right image. Create an enabling relationship among us that will attract people to invest in us. You know, so we do know that someday we'll get there. This company will get, even if I don't get there as the CEO of the company will get there, because this company is not built to cease to exist when I don't exist. This company is built to continue to exist even in my absence. The succession plan in this place, it's one of the best in the world, you know. So one is confident that someday we're going to get there, very confident.
Well, let me take this lighter mood, really, because engineering is about 24 hours of thinking and designing and all of that, and which means you must be on your toes every time, because it has to be done with precision, whatever you're doing. But you must have some time for leisure. See, you know, what do you like to do when you have just a little time to unwind or do some other things that could refresh your mind and put you in the right state of mind?
What I do, in fact, I think, let me tell you a bit about myself. One is I'm an athlete. I'm a very good athlete. I'm a good footballer. I like to play golf. I have one of the best golf kits. But creating time to play golf is my biggest challenge. So what I do with my time is the church. If I'm not working, I'm in the church. If I'm not in the church, I'm at home. But I don't joke with workout. I do a lot of aerobics, you know, so at my spare time, I do a lot of workout, I do aerobics, but the church work takes a greater part of my time. Church work, and also community affairs, you know. I try to give my best to my town, to make it one of the best I'm currently the president general of my town, you know, and the town gave me a chieftaincy title called Ochudo. Ochudo is like a peacemaker. Actually, it's a peacemaker. That's why in some of my my social media, you see the peace ambassador, you know. So it's a responsibility I took up with the intention to bring a new lease of life in my town and show that you could actually do service in your town and remain clean.
Well, indeed, Engineer Akuwe, I want to thank you very much for sharing your thoughts with us and also telling us some of the offerings of GGI International Limited and also the components and the position of the organization in this industry. Let me congratulate you, because on Friday you will be one of those to receive the Inside Business Commendation Award and the Business Manager of the Year by Inside Business Africa. So congratulations in advance. We'll get to see you on Friday. When we come back right after this commercial break, we'll talk more on IBCA and OPAR Awards. Well, it all started about 20 years ago, Inside Business Africa, to be precise, in 1995. And this particular platform has been waxing strong, delivering value to the international community and Nigeria. And indeed, the lecture series also started just about 20 years ago. And as a matter of fact, the first lecture was actually given by the person that is going to deliver the 22nd edition, Mazi Sam Ohabua. At that time, he talked about vision. This time, he's going to talk about adapting to change. So you want to stay out to see what is going to happen on Friday, the 24th of March, 2017. It's going to be Inside Business Africa Commendation Award and Outstanding Projects and Business Leaders Award. Quite a number of personalities are going to be there. We're going to learn, really, it's not just about an award. We're going to learn how Mazi Ohabua was able to transform Pfizer into Nimet International and sustaining the kind of human capital that moved from that level to the next. And that's about all we have time for on Inside Business Africa for today. Thank you again for watching. See you next time.